In this Q&A video, we'll be answering the question, do I need to monitor the amount of electricity my building uses? Now, this question relates to the video that Gary and Gordon made on the Schneider power tag, which is an incredibly powerful device for monitoring and measuring the electricity used by a circuit, along with a load of really impressive other features. So if you haven't seen it, then go and watch that video because it really is very clever. But why would you want to measure the amount of electricity that your building is using? Well, as Gordon said in that video, if you can measure it, you can manage it. And there's a lot of truth in that. If you can see a spike in energy usage or a sustained period of overuse, you can track down what's causing that to happen and then maybe find loads that have been left on needlessly and then correct the problem. So that's one advantage of measuring and monitoring energy usage. But is there a requirement to do so? Well, in approved document L2A of the building regulations, we find some information to help us answer this. Under the heading Energy Meters, in paragraph 2.47, we read, reasonable provision for energy meters would be to install energy metering systems that enable A, at least 90% of the estimated annual energy consumption of each fuel to be assigned to the various end-use categories, heating, lighting, etc. Detailed guidance on how this can be achieved is given in SIBSE TM39 Building Energy Metering, and B, the output of any renewable system to be separately monitored, and C, in buildings with a total useful floor area greater than 1,000 square metres, automatic meter reading and data collection facilities. So a clear need for the monitoring of energy use in new non-domestic properties, and one of the reasons that you often see circuits separated into two distribution boards for lighting and power. But we also find a little more information in paragraph 12.4 in section 12 of the Non-Domestic Building Services Compliance Guide, where we read, the lighting should be metered to record its energy consumption in accordance with the minimum standards in Table 43. And then when we turn to Table 43, we're given three options to do this. The first of which is as simple as this, kilowatt hour meters on dedicated lighting circuits in the electrical distribution. So adding the power tag from Schneider to the relevant circuits of your installation would help you to meet the requirements of Part L and the recommendations in the compliance guide. But as always, we want to hear from you. Have you used the Schneider power tag and unleashed some of its more powerful functions? How do you meet the requirement for metering and monitoring in Part L? Do you think that it can help to manage the amount of energy that a building uses? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. All that remains in this video is to say, thank you very much for watching.